No, no, go ahead. That's all right. Don't worry. Upside down.
I'm gonna do it. I think I'll wait to get a picture till we're.
I thought you already got a few pictures.
What? I didn't get any really good ones. I got one at the beginning, but not really. So we're gonna go on.
On that one next.
I don't think Milton went on that last time. You're gonna like this one, Milton. It's a little roller coaster. Super short though. Literally, it's a mini coaster, but it's fun. The last time we came here, this thing was like a 40-something minute wait.
This little one?
Yeah. And we had Alfredo with us. You know where to go, Alfredo. Well, just wait for us, so we'll get a Milton. There you go, Milton.
Scary stuff. We have two more dates for Halloween Horror Nights this Friday and Saturday. Come back and see it. Right now we're taking it into London Square. They strategically made this area look a little bit different than our other metropolitan sets. It can be London, Washington, D.C., any sort of college campus, and it'll only film a certain part of it, so you don't see the whole thing. It doesn't give it away that it's on a movie studio. And right next to it, we've had a lot of big blockbuster movies like The Amazing Spider-Man, Captain America, The First Avenger, and Transformers film. It's a lot easier to film out here than it is to film in a big city. It's because it's a very controlled environment. Uh-oh, you might see some gruesome things coming up. Just ignore that. Now all these buildings here, they're what we call facades. They're just the fronts and the sides of the building. We really only have to build what the camera will see, and your imagination will later fill in the rest. It's very easy to change the storefronts into whatever we want them to be, whatever time period. In fact, we turned this into the 1920s for a new Ben Affleck movie called Live by Night. And all the building materials, they're very easy to change around. All the brick that you see, it's not real brick. It's plastic sheeting molded to look like brick. There's a lot of styrofoam, foam rubber, that kind of thing. We have another great picture opportunity here to your right of these sets. Now, we had the help of award-winning director Steven Spielberg to design the sets that you just saw. We had the help of another award-winning director, Peter Jackson, on King Kong 363.
It's the original King Kong that made me want to direct movies. I saw that movie on TV when I was about 8 or 9 years old, and I wanted to become a filmmaker.
Action!
I like films that just take you away from your real life and sweep you up in the head. adventure. Cole literally does that. I mean, you're on board the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Skull Island, and it's great to have you along for the ride. Now, we have created this 3D immersive experience, so you're going to have to have your glasses ready.
Be fire. The roof is on fire. We're just gonna blame this on the next tram. This is more paperwork than I really want to fill out today, so let's just get the door open and get out of here. Oh no, wait, that's the wrong door. Okay, I think it's over. Oh no, what's that? There's water, there's water. Give yourselves a big round of applause. You just survived earthquakes of your life. That was an 8.3 magnitude scale simulated earthquake. In the water, making sure there's nothing else out there. Everyone say hi, George.
Hi, George.
Oh, no. I think I was wrong about that shark. We didn't catch the big one. Okay, everybody, I need you to wave your arms, get George's attention, say, get out of there, George. Just a couple people up here. Everyone else just wants to videotape this. That's real nice, guys. It's okay, George. It doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. Except for sharks. Does look like sharks will kill you. Okay, that's not good. Let's hide behind some gasoline. That is a great idea when a giant shark is chasing you. Okay, he could be coming from anywhere. He's pulling at that barrel. He's gonna take the whole pier out with him. Uh-oh, you're on your own. Watch you all when that happens, because everyone does the same thing. You all scream and then you start laughing. It's hard to tell if you're scared or having fun. Don't be too scared of our shark. Oh, look, he's gonna swim backwards. He's a lot less scary when he's going that way. And very talented. He's doing the backstroke. He works a lot better than the shark on the set of Jaws. That shark did not work well at all. In fact, he sunk to the bottom of the ocean on the very first day of filming. That's because they built the shark in a freshwater pit inside one of our sound stages, and then later brought him out to the location in the salt water. The tuna did not mix well.
That's
the fucking
shark. The shark is frustrated. It didn't really work all the time. It didn't work probably at all. Wherever you were on the island,
see several facades built around it. Those were created for about a boy. They turned that into a San Francisco neighborhood. But we're going to take you to a more whimsical neighborhood right now. We are headed... Uh-oh. Mark just pointed that out to me. Do you guys see that car? I need to call that into security. That thing does not have a parking pass.
This is security. What's going on, studio tour?
Yeah, we have looks like a 1970s Dodge Charger sitting out here by the chicken ranch. Doesn't have a parking pass.
Okay, tour. I'll send someone down to check it out ASAP.
Yeah, just, you know, it's important to maintain security whenever. Oh, now these threats are made of styrofoam. Out here, they use 2 million linear feet of styrofoam to construct the sets, 9 football fields worth of snow, and 1,938 candy canes to decorate. The Whoville cars are golf carts dressed to look like that. This area has been a little invaded by our terror tram for Halloween Horror Nights. Now, the Whos not only live next to a Grinch, but their other next-door neighbor, well, he was a little bit of a psycho. Welcome to the Bates Motel. Anybody want to check in? I hear they have killer rates this time of year. If you've been dying to stay there, Norman has been slashing prices. I think you can talk to him at the Psycho House up on the hill. Oh yeah, it does look like he's out here. Feel free to let him know if you want to stay. He's not always the nicest, but... Don't mind us, just drive by. crash site for War of the Worlds, directed by Steven Spielberg. We're going to come to a stop so you can stand up and take pictures. This is a real Boeing 747 that you're looking at. Here's what it looks like with Tom Cruise at the coat of fanning.
The airplane crashed down right in a big neighborhood because it's just something you don't see.
You're doing good. You're doing good. Keep your eyes on me. Listen, close your eyes, okay? Got them closed? Robbie, get in. Get in.
The plane cost $60,000 to buy, but it cost $200,000.